What is up, y'all? It's Pepper Barbie here, back with a brand new video.
He asked me which way I liked it. I told him I like my shit from back, 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 back.
And it's Amber Duck.
As you can tell by the title, I'm gonna be helping some of y'all start y'all YouTube channel or go on with y'all YouTube channels and things people do not tell y'all as being a small YouTuber. So this is basically gonna be everything from my perspective, my experience, and basically my advice to y'all, because a lot of people have different advice than others and mine's probably the same, but mine is worded differently and better understanding. If you're new to my channel, hey y'all, make sure to subscribe, hit the bell so you won't miss a video by me. If you're a real OG and been subscribed to my channel, hey y'all, welcome back. Y'all like my hair? Period. I just slay. So y'all know me, I write everything like in my little book, whatever. So I'm going to be reading off here. If y'all catch me looking down, then you know I'm looking at this. So yeah, so the first thing is the usual, to be yourself. And everybody should know not to be like anybody else, because you're your own person and your own person only. Period. Yeah, just try to be yourself. Don't try to like copy anyone else on YouTube. Like me, let's not even get to the copying. But I know a lot of people that try to copy me, but you know, it's just like, just let them be, because they can never be like me. You could try to copy me, but you're not going to be close to me, because I'm me and you're you. So we're two different people, so you can't really do what I do. Yeah, just try not to copy. Number two, be original. You can do the same videos as what anybody do, because it's not like it's somebody's idea. Unless it's a new trend on YouTube and it's their idea and you want to do it too, make sure to give them credit. But other than that, just try not to copy nobody, because copying, somebody gonna notice, and it's not gonna be good for you or everybody else, because you think copying is a good thing, but then people gonna start noticing, oh, you don't act like this, or you don't usually do this, so they're gonna say you're copying. So try not to copy. You can do the same video ideas, but try to do your own. Number three, have a meaning behind your YouTube name. So mine is Life with the Barbie, for example. And I know I'm a pretty gal, and like, I'm precise, I'm a good person, you know, I'm encouraging, and I'm just that. So that's basically what I will put the word Barbie in my definition. So that's why it's Life with the Barbie, because it's just my life, what I do, and just me, a Barbie. Yeah, a lot of people do say, like, a lot of people do get why I put Barbie, because like a lot of people, I don't know, I just don't tell people, but they just know. Like sometimes they be like, now I know why you put your YouTube name as Life with the Barbie. So you have to get people to say that same thing about you, because when people say that about my YouTube name, like, I'm proud. I'm like, oh, okay, you get the meaning behind my name and what I do. So yeah, like, if people do not get your YouTube name, then you're gonna have to change it or put in something else. Number four, take your time to edit your video. And I mean, like, if you are starting your YouTube channel and you are a small YouTuber, let's say, and you're having struggles editing your videos, like, a lot of people ask me how I do this, how I do that. Just YouTube it. Like, how I become a YouTuber, you have to watch YouTube videos and you have to learn how to become a YouTuber from YouTube. So if you don't know how to edit, just look it up on YouTube. Just YouTube it. Number five, also make decent thumbnails. If you don't know how to do thumbnails, just YouTube it as well, because me, I make my thumbnails my type of way. I don't try to copy nobody like that, but everybody's thumbnails gonna somehow look the same, but you have your own little twist to it. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, try not to also copy people. Also, YouTube how to do thumbnails as well. You're not gonna get it exactly how they do it, which is a good thing, because you need to know how to do your own thumbnails. And when you learn how to make thumbnails as good, then you can try adding your little twist to it to see like how your thumbnail is gonna turn out. Number six, have in mind that you want to be a YouTuber. And from my perspective, I wanted to be a YouTuber because I felt like that's something I've been wanting to do. Like, it was just right there in front of me, and I'm just louching, you know, and I'm just like, oh, how about I just post my first video, see how it get. My first video got around 1.5k. It'll probably be right there or right here, I don't know, but I kind of got that for my first video. And then I was really proud of myself because I knew I could do that. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, if you know you wanna do YouTube because you feel inside yourself that you have a place in YouTube in life, then do it. Oh, you can get paid. Or, oh, people doing it and they're getting paid or they're going big. Like, you're not gonna grow big as somebody if you just think that way. Like, you have to, like, have it in your heart that you want to do it. Not just, oh, because she doing it. Oh, I want this money. Like, it takes time to get paid on YouTube. Like, what I'm telling you, like, But that's not really just why I want to do YouTube. It's because it's me and I live for it and I'm used to it already. Like, I been wanting to do YouTube. Number 7, have good quality. You do not need no camera to do YouTube. Like, especially for small YouTubers, you do not need no camera. You can use your iPhone or Android. If you got good quality on your Android, then use it. I have iPhone 11. I used to record on my 8 Plus, but it was kind of, my camera was getting trashed, but my phone was not working no more like it used to. So, you know, I got a new phone for more better quality and for other reasons too. But you do not need the 11 or XR, none of that for good quality. You can use a 5S, a 6S, and still be recording. I know a lot of people that records on their 6S, and you know the 6S run down battery fast, and it barely got storage. But people try to use a 6S or a 5 to record your video. So you do not need a good phone. Just get good quality. Number 8, you do not need no type of ring light. Like, when I first started my channel, I did not have no ring light. I had to use natural lighting, but I do not remember when. I know it was way before Christmas, you know, so it's really not different, because natural lighting with the ring light, you know, it kind of brightens me up. But $80 to $100 for a ring light or a professional ring light. You can get a little phone ring light, you know, put on your phone or whatever, but you don't need a ring light at all for that type of good quality. So if you got a window that you know that the sun be blooming through, you better open up them blinds, scroll them up. Because if you know you want to do YouTube and you want to do this, like, yes, I want to do this. So you better lift up them blinds and start recording from that natural lighting. To start getting up to that level, you probably do, like, need a ring light for sure. Because a lot of people watching your videos and, you know, you just want to be like, okay, I want people to be able to see me clearly, hear me clearly, and just da-da-da. So yeah. Number 9, be patient and consistent. Like, you have to keep uploading, especially when you're starting your channel and a small YouTuber. You gotta keep uploading. I'm not saying to upload every day, like, just keep uploading, like, probably every 2 days or every other day. You just want to make sure you're active, because don't be thinking, oh, you got this certain amount of views. Let's say you got 10,000 views on this one video that went viral, and you think, oh, let me just take a break off YouTube real quick, because, you know, people gonna still watch my videos. Then you taking a break for 2 weeks to 1 month, and you come back, you post a video, and your views are going from here to down here. Like me, I made that biggest mistake, because I took a break for 1 month because I ran out of ideas. I didn't know what to do, and I just wanted a nice background or whatever to film my videos, and my views started to drop. So, you know, I regret that, but my views are coming back up because I started to be active and I started to be more encouraging to others, and I just started doing good things. If you rush it, then your time is not gonna come. Like, don't, like, try to keep posting too much, overloading, and you're not getting type of views and likes that you need. Number 10, have uploading days. I don't have uploading days. I post when I feel like it, but I do make sure I post every day or every other day, because I'm trying to make the time for it. So if I miss around 3 days, then I'm trying to make up my time. But other than that, have uploading days, especially for small YouTubers. Like, especially, so let's say I post every Wednesdays and Fridays, so that's good. You have to make sure people know, like, when you upload as well. Also, make sure you have a time when you upload. Okay, I'm post around 5 o'clock every Wednesdays and Fridays or whatever, because, you know, let's say we're still in school and you have an upload time, so when people come back from school, you know, they can take a shower, eat their lunch or dinner or whatever, and, you know, oh, Life with a Barbie, we're gonna post a video at 5 o'clock and today Wednesday, like, I gotta get ready. So, you know what I'm saying? So make sure you have that time and the days you're gonna be posting, especially if you're a small YouTuber and starting your channel. So the next thing, promote yourself. A lot of people now is gonna hate on you because you have a YouTube channel now and you think you're gonna get big. So your friends, so-called friends, is not gonna support you. But if some of them support you, then that's your friend for sure. But people, like, when you, like, you have to promote yourself a whole bunch of times and just keep in front of yourself, because people gonna be like, why is you just shouting yourself out? Like, girl, you want to get up there, so of course you're gonna have to keep promoting yourself. Every time you post a video, you post it on your story or whatever, like, keep promoting yourself. Also, do not beg for somebody to promote you, because they could be your best friend and she lacking or whatever and she don't want to support you. So don't beg, just don't push it. And the last thing is, this is kind of going to number 11, but if your friends do not support you, then that's most definitely not your friend. Because, or if your friend think y'all in competition, so let's say she started a YouTube channel and you wanted to do it too because you felt like, oh, I want to do this as well, and you getting up to the top and she's still down here and she thinking y'all in competition and she not supporting you no more, then that's not your friend, baby. Because if your friend think y'all in competition with each other, then that's most definitely not your friend, because friends are not supposed to compete with each other when coming to a business like this. For that being said, if she's not support, or if she or he is not supporting you, then, you know, that's no. See, but you know, I don't worry about that and I just let it be. So if you think I'm gonna change and you think I'm gonna cut you off, then just cut me off first, because that's what you want. But when I start getting up there, do not try to find your way to be friends with me. Because once before, you said you didn't want to be my friend because you think, oh, I'm changing or whatever since I got my little business. So if I'm changing, then you can stay there, because I will never, ever, ever, and I do not ever, ever, ever beg for somebody to be my friend. So it is what it is, you know. So yeah, so that brings us to the end of this video. I'm gonna try to cut this video a little short because it is getting a little long. I did not expect it to be this long. But if y'all really enjoyed this video, give this video a thumbs up. Make sure to share with your friends that you know that starting a YouTube channel or in the processing of starting or need help with their channel. Make sure to comment down below if any of these tips help y'all, because I really want to know, like, did this help y'all or not. Thank y'all for watching. Love y'all. Stay safe. Peace out.